Hello everybody, lately I've been working on adding node support for Malt, and yeah, it's still work in progress but good enough to be used. And here I'm going to teach you the basic on how to use it. For now I'm releasing only for my Patreons, but it will be eventually added to the main version of Malt in GitHub. Okay, so we first make sure we are using Malt and create a new area, set it to Malt node tree type. Okay, as a new node, if we try to add anything, it says no graph type select. Shaders in Malt have different types like mesh, light and screen, and right now only mesh shaders are available from nodes, but yeah, adding the other types should be quite easy, they will come later. So the first thing we need to add is an output, so we go to output, common pixel shader output, and select our node tree, and to be able to edit it we are going to select the struct type pixel output, connect it, and we are going to select the common pixel shader input and use it as the default value for our struct. So right now basically we are not doing anything, just taking the input, the default input, and passing it to the output. Okay, common pixel shader input, common pixel shader output. But right now if we render we just get a black color, but we are ready to override any of these parameters. So the first thing we are going to do is add a node utils library I wrote that basically adds to nodes stuff that is already built in Jelly Cell. Nodes are generated automatically from the Malt source code. So basically every file in the built-in shaders is scanned and made available from the nodes. But yeah, that's also mean that by default there are no functions for the stuff that it's built in GLSL. So stuff like arithmetic, basic types like floats and vectors and stuff like that is not scanned. So I made this little library for adding those functions. Of course, this will be built in the main version, but for now it's a separate library. And it also allows me to show you how it works. So right now, if we press Shift A, we have node utils, vectors or 4D, 3D, 2D, integers, and floats. So we select a vector, save vector property, and now we can select our color. Okay. We can change from here, and it's also available from here. One thing that is different in Malt than in Blender is that the shader tree and the material are different entities. So if we for example duplicate this and duplicate our material, we are still using the same node tree, but if we overwrite the property from the node tree, we can set it a different color for this material. Okay, and say for this one, if we overwrite, we can select a different color. But any change we make to the node tree will affect both of these objects. So if, for example, we have a line, most of the useful functions, the simplified API is here in the MPR mesh shader. We select getLineSimple and plug it into lineWidth, and now both materials will have a line. We are going to scale it by using float multiply by 3. And we are going to use a different color for the line, like for example this one. Okay. And again, you can go back to the default properties anytime. They are both saved. You don't lose the override. So we are going to see how to make a typical material. So again, from mesh shader, we are going to select diffuse hole. We have to convert the 3D vector to a 4D vector, so vector from vec3, plug it here and here, set the alpha to 1, and right now, yeah, okay, we have the diffuse hull. If we want to multiply it by our color, we select vector 3, wait, vector 3 multiply. Oh yeah, if you try to plug two sockets that have different types, like here for example, this is box 4 and this is box 3, it will fail. So instead, we are going to convert from select. Okay. Now we have the color of the originals, or we can also just create a new property. And that's it. Okay. Of course we lose the override. So yeah, by the way, another change I did is that now color ramps are like textures. So they can be shared across different nodes or properties if you are just using code-based shaders. So we are going to select the diffuse gradient, and we are going to set it as our color. By default, we don't have a color ramp. We create a new one. You can edit, okay. And the thing is that you can use it from multiple sides. So from here we can select the same ramp. It's not too useful here, but imagine a situation where you have lots of different nose trees, but for example, you want to use the same tone gradient for all your materials or for a bunch of them. So yeah, I think this is useful in those cases. That yeah, let me know if you prefer this workflow or you prefer just to copy paste or use node groups or whatever. So here we are going to change the color. Change the shadow color too. Okay. Duplicate this. We are going to set to reddish. Oh, I think. Yeah, right now I duplicate. Set to reddish. This one to black. And we are going to add them. The three as. It takes a bit to compile sometimes. Okay, here it is. This is too bright. We are going to lower the value. Maybe, yeah. There's still a lot of work to do. There are still some basics features that are not implemented, like array support, for example. But yeah, the cool thing is that you can always add custom nodes, and it's very easy. I'm going to show you how. So if we open our node utils folder with code, is as simple as hitting a new function. For example, before give me the yellow, it's not going to take any parameter, and it's just going to return a big for with the red value set to 1, the green value set to 1, the blue value set to 0, and the alpha value set to 1. We save this file, and right now if we go to functions, node utils, here is our custom node. Give me the yellow, quick plug it, and here it is. Is that easy? So yeah, that's it for now. Thank you for watching. There's still a lot of work to be done. So if you want to use Malt in your projects or are looking forward to use it in the future, maybe consider going to my Patreon or my Gumroad and support the project. Thank you for watching, and bye.